axial line, this is the perpendicular bisector line. Okay, now on the axial line at a distance of x, what is the magnetic field induction? Mu naught by 4 pi into 2 pi 2m by x square minus l square whole to the power of 2. Now on the perpendicular bisector, on the perpendicular bisector, right, the magnetic field induction mu naught by 4 pi m by x square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2. For a small magnets, therefore, what is the B value? Is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into, that is 2m by x cube. For a small magnets, BE is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into m by x cube. Therefore, now this is about only two magnet. Magnet is there, axial line is there, perpendicular bisector line is there. Around the magnet, there is a magnetic field. In the magnetic field, at any point, we can calculate magnetic field induction. Right? On the axial line, what is the magnetic field induction? BA is equals to mu naught by 4 pi 2m by x square minus l square whole to the power of 2. For a small magnet on the same axial line, it may be simplified as mu naught by 4 pi into 2m by x cube. Now, next, on the perpendicular bisector line, BE is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into m by x square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2. For a small magnet, mu naught by 4 pi m by x cube. Now, this is about your pure magnet. Now, what is my topic? Current carrying circular coil. Now, this is called, what to say, current carrying circular coil. This is the current carrying circular coil. Now, what to say, this is the axis of the coil. Now, what is this one? O is the center. What is the radius? R is the radius. What is the current passing through this one? I. At a distance of x, there is a point P, right? At this point, that means axial line. Here is also axial line, right? For a magnet, there is axial line, right? Now, for a coil, there is axial line. On the axial line, right? At a point P, which is at a distance of x from the center O, right? What is the magnetic field induction? B is equals to mu naught I n by r square by 2 into r square plus x square whole to the power of 3 by 2. Right? Now here in this case, compare these two. Right? What I am going to compare means this current carrying circular coil behaves as a magnetic shell. Right? There is a pure magnet. Here current carrying circular coil also behaves as a magnetic shell. Right? Whenever it is acting as a magnetic shell, what is the magnetic moment? Where is the north pole and where is the south pole? You want to calculate. Now, here in this case, whatever the equation for the magnetic field can be transformed into the magnetic field like this. Now, can be transformed means, right? Now, right? If x is equals to greater than r, x is very high, r is very small. R can be neglected means r square plus x square whole to the power of 3 by 2 is nearly equals to, what to say, x cube. Therefore, B is equals to, what to say, mu naught I n r square by 2 into r square plus x square whole to the power of 3 by 2 is nearly equals to, what to say, x cube. Now, this equation is multiplied with the 2 pi and this equation is divided with the 2 pi. Therefore, this can be rearranged as mu naught, that is 2 into 2, that is 4, and again pi is there. Now here in this case, that is I, that is next one I, right here to pi r square, pi r square, there is a term 2 by what to say x cube. Therefore b is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into, that is here 2 into pi r square is called a circular coil, area of the circular coil, that is n, that is I a is by x cube. Now therefore here this is the equation of the magnetic field induction on the axial line. Therefore on the circular coil, for a circular coil, the magnetic field induction on the axial line, this is the equation. For bar magnet, what is the magnetic field induction? B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi 2m by x cube. Here compare these two, right? Here the magnetic field induction on the axial line. Now this is the magnetic field induction on the axial line due to the current carrying circular coil. Here magnetic field mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi, x cube 2 is there. Now instead of m, what is the term? Nia. Therefore the magnetic moment of the, that is magnetic moment of current carrying circular coil, m is equals to what to say n I a. What is n? Total number of turns. What is I? Current. What is a? Area of the coil. Therefore whenever the current carrying circular coil behaves as a magnetic shell, the magnetic moment is equals to n I a. Now where is the north pole, where is the south pole? Now here the current carrying circular coil, this is the current carrying circular coil, right? This current carrying circular coil has two faces, front face is there, back face. Let us consider current carrying circular coil. Current carrying circular coil, for with respect to you, current is in the clockwise direction. With respect to me, current is in the anti-clockwise direction. Therefore this current carrying circular coil, this is the current carrying circular coil, it has two faces, right? There is a, what to say, front face, front of the current carrying circular coil. Now that is back of the current carrying circular coil. Now current carrying circular coil, current is traveling with respect to you, clockwise direction. Therefore this is the clockwise direction, this is the clockwise direction. With respect to me, that is current is in the anti-clockwise direction, the current is in the anti-clockwise direction. Therefore there is a coil that is through the front surface, what is the current direction? This is the current direction. Through the back surface, what is the current direction? This is the current direction. See carefully, that is, this is the clockwise current. Here this is the clockwise current. Here anti-clockwise current. Here is also anti-clockwise current. Now both are connected like this. Both are connected like this. Therefore, now this is called what to say south pole, this is called what to say north pole. Here the current, that is called clockwise. Here this is called what to say anti-clockwise. Now therefore whenever the current carrying circular coil behaves as a magnetic shell, it has the magnetic moment, it should have the north pole and south pole. Therefore by comparing the magnet to the current carrying circular coil, the magnetic moment can be derived as a NIA. Whenever it is acting as a magnetic shell, where is the north pole, where is the south pole? This is the current carrying circular coil. The face through which the current is passing in the clockwise direction is acting as a south pole, and the face through which the current is traveling in the, that is anti-clockwise direction, is acting as a north pole. Now this is called current carrying circular coil. This has two faces. Through one phase, the current is traveling in the clockwise direction. Through the back phase, the current is traveling in anti-clockwise direction. The phase through which the current is in the clockwise direction, that front phase, that phase acting as a south pole. The phase through which the current is traveling in the anti-clockwise direction behaves as a north pole. Hence, we can conclude that current carrying circular coil behaves as a, that is, magnetic shell.